Jim Jaska was in high school, he knew he wanted to go into research.
I didn't know it would be food research, but I wanted to do something where I was discovering something new. And that excited me.
So he took a lot of chemistry classes in high school and then got a degree in chemistry from Baldwin-Wallace University, leading to his career as a food scientist.
Food scientist's responsibility is to formulate new food products using ingredients that exist or ingredients that have to be created in order to make a product function.
Jim says the food industry is extremely competitive with product development, and you can see that just by going into a grocery store.
The consumers right now are driving the health and wellness part of the food industry, which is why you've got a Whole Foods, a Trader Joe's, and all those places that are really focused on all natural ingredients, farm to table, things that are grown locally that are put into food products, and that is a big driving force in what's going on today.
These trends help determine what kind of products food scientists will develop.
It's a very, very difficult challenge. They're always sourcing new ingredients. If you go the organic route, then you have to find natural organic ingredients in order to formulate.
Another challenge is making the product taste the same, whether made in a small batch or on a huge scale.
The food scientist has got to develop a formula that can be duplicated to make a million units of the same thing over and over and over again, very consistently. And there's another part of food science and technology that's involved with quality control, quality assurance, food safety, and those things are all critical to getting a successful product out into the market.
Jim says there are an unlimited number of careers that fit under the food science and technology umbrella.
Typically, it's based on product development because that's where the business is. But there's a lot of support that goes into making a good product. And those are all technical positions.
He says to be a food scientist, you need a college degree, most likely in science.
Chemistry, biology, biochemistry, microbiology, those are all scientific degrees that are the basis for what we do. And from that basis, you develop experience to develop new products, to support the development of new products, to support the quality of new products, and also to identify ingredients that are going to function properly in new products. So
typically, food scientists work in a lab environment in research and development organizations.
The research part of it is the looking for the scientific evidence of something that works. The development part of it is taking that and putting it into something practical, like a finished food product.
He says some small companies have just one scientist, while large companies may have hundreds. And some people have more advanced degrees and get into the science behind specific ingredients, like a friend of his at Heinz, who has a PhD and specializes in tomatoes.
He has to go around the world, and they have to be able to make ketchup in any part of the world, given what the tomatoes are in that part of the world. And he has to source those tomatoes to make sure that a ketchup in India tastes like a ketchup in the United States.
Heinz!
Okay, madam.
And don't forget biscuit, eh?
Okay, madam.
Okay.
According to the United States Bureau of Labor Statistics, a food scientist or technologist makes on average $66,870 a year. But there's plenty of opportunity for advancement, according to Jim, especially in certain areas like working in flavor chemistry.
Flavor chemistry is actually one of those scientific disciplines where you can advance. And you can advance. If you become a principal flavorist at a flavor company, they command upper six-figure salaries because of what they bring to the party. And companies are in demand because they know how to tweak flavors, manipulate flavors, and get the end result to what the companies are looking for.
Jim says students interested in going into the field of food science can start preparing while still in school by taking science classes like chemistry and biology and focusing on statistically oriented math classes.
Because there's a lot of statistics involved in not only the product development side of it, but also the processing side. They have to be able to analyze what they're making and making sure that there's nothing wrong with it.
And there's one big thing that should motivate you if you're interested in following the food science path.
You gotta have a passion for food. If you don't have a passion for food, don't go into this industry because it's not for you. You gotta have a passion for food.